Hi everyone, it's Taff. Welcome back to Agricultural Simulator 2013. Here we are, we're back on the US West map with our little sheepsies. And Neddy the horse is still ignoring me. Ned! Neddy! Ned! Ned! Nedster! Neddy dude! Neddy dude! No, fine. No love from the horse, but Gallus loves us still, don't you, Gallus? Yeah, good boy, Gallus. Good boy, Gallus. Let's give him a little scratch on the head. Right, so last time we bought the hovering butterfly mower, by the looks of it, and we bought the tipper trailer, we bought the forage wagon, we bought the sprayer, and did we buy anything else? No, I don't think we bought anything else. That's enough, to be honest with you, didn't we? We bought the front mower as well. And we seeded the field. Great. Okay, so I thought today we could get some grass getting mowed, because we desperately need it. We don't desperately need it, but we do need to get it done. I don't know why I said we desperately need it. That was a blatant lie to you people, and I hope you will forgive me in time. Right, let's just hitch up. Oh, goodness me. This game is so different from every other game. You have to remember how to play the damn thing. Clunk click, stick the old PTOs on, clunk click, right, okay, great, and now let's go and get the front one. Now we could have just used the front one and the collection wagon behind it, but we didn't go that way. We decided to splash the cash and we went for the full effect butterfly mower and front mower as well. Struggling to speak at the moment, I don't know why. Right, let's get the PTO, that kind of works. Okay, we might need to raise that a touch. Can we, front hydraulics, can you raise that please? Can you raise that? Front hydraulics, can we raise that? We can't lower it, can we? Okay. That's just very low to the ground if you ask me, but there we go. We can't raise it. So let's go over to the grass meadow and start a cutting. Got so much land to cut, look at this. We'll start near the edge of the field, not right up to the edge, but pretty close. Ooh, autosave, I hope. Yep, thank goodness for that. Panic over everyone, panic over. Right, so let's drop the rear hydraulics. Activate them, clunk, wow, and away we should go. Okay, the front one's not cutting. Okay, lower the front. Now it's cutting, okay, so there's just a weirdness with the front cutter, which, it just doesn't register too much movement on the old animation side. That's fine. We're going to leave, obviously, a bit of grass between us and the edge of the field. That's fine, so we can drive on that without damaging the crops. And we don't have to at all. We could go right up to the edge. But I'm just trying to role play a little bit. So we'll keep an edge. And, God, I cannot drive in a straight line, can I? Goodness me. Yeah, if we get this cut, it'd be interesting. There's the yellow markers over there. I don't know if you can see those on the little ridge there. I'll go around the outside actually, and we'll go like a ever decreasing circle. Let's not try and cut it too tightly. There we go. That's not too bad. Because if you cut, or ooh, there's a ridge in the ground there. If you cut or do anything, plow anything, which on land, which is in your designated border, you will be fined for. So we're right on the edge of these yellow posts here, and we're coming up to the other yellow post markers. So we'll make another turn here. It's a shame we don't have that plot of land. Oops, we actually run down the side of it. I turned that a little bit sharp. Because this is a weird one, because it sort of runs here. You can see these yellow markers, and then it sort of runs straight down there behind the greenhouse and kind of on that path as well. So it's a bit weird how that works, but hey ho. And then we don't have any markers here, which makes it a bit of guesswork, to be honest with you. But yeah, We don't need to do all of it anyway. This is going to be so much grass. We'll be actually laughing. Yeah, the animals will be well fed, and the grass bin will be full. Which reminds me, we could potentially get a silage pit as well. Oh, look, we're actually mowing on somebody else's ground. Okay, we kind of just got away with that because the markers were not very clear. We'll just come around here. Wonder if we can, yeah, we can ramp up the intensity of the old mowing and go a little bit quicker. Ooh, although the tractor becomes a little bit more of a handful. Let's just slow down a bit and we'll go up this side here. It's not the best attempt, I grant you, but you know, this is, it's getting all the basics, what's all we need. We might need to get a tedder and a windrower and maybe a baler as well. Because, you know, we don't probably need all this grass. We can probably bale some of it for hay. But for that, we need to turn it. So, yeah. That's a thought. Right, let's slow down a touch. And we'll come around here. Probably did that not the best. Not the best, I'll admit that myself, that wasn't the best. But, you know, we're getting through this in no time. And this way, we don't want to be spending, you know, an hour cutting grass. Oh, blimey, it's gone dark, isn't it? The sun's gone in behind a cloud. Either that or the rain's coming. Okay, there's a little bit we didn't get there, but that's fine. We're not going to get all of it, it doesn't matter. Whoa, this tractor's got a life of its own, just drive straight. So yeah, this is what we'll do. We'll get this cut today. We'll get some of it collected as well. And then we'll also maybe look to... How much money have we got? We've got £44,998. So we could potentially get a tedder. I know the baler's quite cheap as well. The old-fashioned one, the old square baler. That's quite cheap. So we could potentially get that one. Or we could just... Whoa! Tank slapper. There we go. Oh, it's a beautiful lattice effect. Look at that. I couldn't do that again, but wow. Looks like a curly whirly, doesn't it? If anyone knows what a curly whirly looks like. It's a chocolate bar in the UK. With all caramel inside, with, you know, surrounded with chocolate. It's lovely. It's all soft and chewy and a bit of a kid's treat, but it's nice. There's an autosave again. Okay, look at this. This tractor does not want to turn with these attachments on it. So I'm thinking we probably need to stop. Well, the problem is if I have to stop going around in circles, then and coming back and forth, there's going to be a lot of faffing about. But I guess that's what we have to do to try and keep this reasonably neat. Making short work of it, though, aren't we? Which is pretty good to see. So let's cut it up to there. And deactivate them. Wow. That's mighty impressive, isn't it? Is this going to be quicker long term? Probably not. But we'll do this anyway. Right, let's get the front mower on. And the back mower's on. And away we go. Okay. So yeah, we'll get this bit of land. We could potentially, with the 44 grand, we could potentially invest it in the little seed trailer, which put bags them up. So for animal feed, we might need that, but we won't get that straight away because we've got enough animal feed in bags for now. When I say animal feed, I mean the corn and I mean the wheat, which we can feed the animals. So that's potential there. We'll get that later. It's only going to be, it's a historical farm piece, so it's going to be relatively cheap as they go, so I wouldn't worry too much about that. The tedder and the liner might be a little bit more pricey. I can't remember in this game if you only need to buy one and they do the same thing. Obviously in like the farming simulators, you'll have both tools to complete the job, but I think in this one you only need the one. Cool. Yeah, nice. It's quite nice effect, isn't it, when the grass is all piled in rows like that. It looks very neat and tidy, very symmetrical. We can maybe do some art with this mower, if I had any talent as well. You could like do drawings, couldn't you? Which would be really cool, but we're not going to, because I just A, don't have the artistic ability, and B, don't have the time to figure it out. But hey ho, let's keep mowing. We're here for farming, not art. So with this done, we kind of are committing ourselves to keeping animals, aren't we? Otherwise this is a waste of time. We've already invested in the mowers and the forage wagon. So I guess we will have to do animals. Let's not worry about the potential crashing and corruption of saves on this game. You know, that's going to happen. It's going to happen anyway. So let's just go with the animals. We may run out of milk tray, egg boxes, and we may run out of milk urns, but we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. There's no point worrying about it before it ever happens, because it may neither happen, and we would be missing out on a big chunk of the game. So okay, we will do that. Oh, this tractor is a little bit difficult to drive at times when it's just doing a sharp turn. It's kind of got those physics that never quite right in the farming simulator. It's like Farm Sim 15. You know, the cars and the vehicles, they're okay. They're a lot, you know, they're quite solid, but they do feel a little bit twitchy and especially the pickup trucks. They go whizzing off in all sorts of directions and just uncontrollable at times. Likewise with the tractor with a tipper full of some sort of grain, will also be, you know, spun around if you're going down a hill at any reasonable speed at so easily, almost as if the actual tractor itself has no weight, and that could be a bit of a problem. I've spun out many a time, and that can happen in real life, but you know, the tractor does have a fair bit of weight about it as well. But we'll see. Now, one of the other things I talked about it in the last episode of this. Oh, autosave. Or crash. What do you reckon? Autosave. There we go. All bets are off. It was an autosave. The last... Wow, we've actually done... Look at that. Look what we've done. Wow, that's actually really quite impressive. I was talking about Playway's new farm game, which I thought it was going to be called Pro Farmer 2015, beg your pardon. Professional farmer, that is. Because I think Jack sent me a link to where it was being advertised. Now, I contacted Playway, I think I probably explained this already, and they've said, oh no, it's not going to be called Professional Farmer 2015, but there is a farm sim game coming out, and I think it's going to be called Farming Machinery, I think it is. So far, I believe it's already released the 5th of December, but only in Poland. So I don't know if they've got plans to release that in the rest of the EU and the world. At this stage, I don't know. Playway did say they'd let me know more information, but whether or not they will, who's to say? They probably get so many correspondents, they've probably forgotten already. But that would be interesting to see if that is coming out. It's very much reusing the models and the actual the engine of Professional Farmer 2014, i.e. the Unity engine, which and the terrain and graphics they developed in that. So yeah, so they were reusing what they've already developed, but there were some very interesting additions which they'd made, which I was kind of quite interested in. But we'll see whether or not that ever comes to the UK. If it does, then I may ask for a review copy. If not, well, I don't think it is. Otherwise, why would you just limit it to Poland on release? It's probably just going to be a local release, and they're probably a little bit stung from their work with UIG, to be honest with you, and they probably fear that they're going to be their reputation has been a little bit too far damaged for the rest of the world. But, hey-ho, we will see. That could be completely wrong surmise, so we'll see what turns out. But look at that field. Look at that field. Fully cut. Wow, that's actually quite impressive to look at. Fine for working on foreign land. I am not. I'm just literally just driving on it. Look at that. £1,000 fine for just driving on their land. Oh. Jeez. I don't know. That's a bit harsh, I thought. Right, so where should we park this mower? Should we park the mower in the shed with the combine? That sounds like a good idea. They are a bit grubby, but... yeah, that front mower looks just broken, doesn't it? Will it not lift? No. It won't lift. Right, so let's, oh, sorry, pressed the wrong key. With that on the front, we may have problems getting in, so I'm going to back in to see if that helps. No, because that mower, can I lift that up? Yes, okay. Let's give this a second. There we go, we're in. Let's park this up against the wall there. There we go. Lost my bearings Thank you very much. That's really helpful. I appreciate you doing that. Right, I'm not sure how we're gonna... Oh, let's just drop this butterfly cutter, because God knows this will probably flip over and do something crazy as well. Oh! Yeah, they're all upside down. Well done. Brilliant. Well, we better make sure we collect all this grass, because we may never be able to use our mowers again. And if we connect them up to the tractor, they will probably spin around in the air in weird physics banding, all sorts of craziness. Ah, joy. Ah, joy. That's the problem with these farming games. The physics still isn't right on any of them, is it? So, we've got the grass done. Have another look at that. Fantastic. We can start to collect it. So, let's get trailers full. But what are we doing now, actually? Let's just have a look. Oh no, we don't want to paint or wash. Do we want to wash our tractor? It's not really grubby yet, is it? It's not really grubby yet. Tractor's supposed to be grubby. No, forget that. Auto save completed. Great. I wanted to press P. P. No. Is it O? It was O. Why is it? Let me just move away. No, I do not want to upgrade it. Why won't you let me go to the shop? Let's just move the tractor. Oh, well, hang on. There we go. We were too close to the actual the barn where it's got a little icon where you can work on vehicles, i.e. wash them and upgrade them, that kind of thing. When I say upgrade them, you can paint them. So what we were looking at? We were looking at extensions, and we were looking at a stirrer. Who you stirrer are you? Okay, there don't appear to be any stirrers. What about liners? Here we go. So we've got this one for 14 grand, which is quite a big one, although those wheels do appear to be not connected to anything. I think, should they be connected to this, maybe? Maybe? these things, like, you know, the wheel there, and that should be a wheel there, okay, maybe not that one. 15 grand for this one, yes, that one looks more intact, so... okay, we can buy that, and let's have a look for a baler. Baling technology, we have this big square baler for 145,000. Can't afford that. So let's go historical and see what they can offer us. So they can offer us this is the little baler, which is 5,200, which should be fine. This little trailer is the one we need for bagging grain into bags. That's why it's called bagging, I guess. That's 4,600. And what's the stirrer, as they like to call it in here? There we go. The Vicon Acrobat. That's £1,500. That's bargain basement, that, isn't it? Anyway, okay, so that's great. So we got the money. Let's go and start collecting some with the forage wagon to get some grass collected. Because I think if we start to stir it, it will... It will instant... What is... Oh, I'm clipping something invisible. Hang on. There's an invisible clip point there. That's what I hit. No, that time I did actually just hit the barn, but that's fine. So, yeah. PTO to PTO. As I was saying, I think, if memory serves me right, if we start to stir it, it'll instantly turn to hay, and obviously you want to collect some grass first. Oh, we're clipping everything. Let's just zoom out a bit. Is that the farthest we can go? Let's see if we can get further. That seems to be the furthest we can go. Okay. So let's start on with this. Let's activate. Is it going? I think it's going. Yes, it's collecting. Let's try and drive straight now, which is not always my forte. As you can see, look at this tractor. Oh my goodness. Right, let's just jump in cab. Maybe that'd be the easiest way to drive straight. Is it collecting? Yes, it's collecting grass. Fantastic. Woof! Okay, rough start, but we're away. But look at all this. Look at all this mowed grass. That is fantastic. Let's just have a quick look how that's collecting. Oh, quite quickly, actually. Quite quickly. You're probably going to get, what, 2,000 and a bit? 2,500 for one stripe? Wow, this will fill up in no time. Yeah, so we'll get a load, maybe two loads of grass. Then we'll get some spun and dried out for hay. We'll get some hay collected as well. We'll buy the baler as well, so we'll get some bales. Oh, we'll probably need to bale some grass rows as well, won't we? So we'll get the grass and the hay. And then obviously we've got half a field worth of wheat growing. So we can also then bale the straw, so that's good. We got and be able to fill up the hayloft with all those three types of bales, so that's a good bonus. Now I think the straight line from the end of these yellow markers to the greenhouse is not a straight line, or not quite the straight line we took. So autosave, don't worry. I think we may potentially get fined for collecting grass over here. Just keep an eye out on the bottom left-hand corner just to see if we get fined. We may do, we may not do. And the reason I say that, if we come towards the greenhouse, you can see there's a marker just literally a foot behind the greenhouse edge there, and just in front. So yeah, we are kind of stealing a little bit of grass from our neighbours, but I'm sure they're okay. Come on, it's only a bit of grass. We've worked side by side for so long. Okay, I didn't do the best of turns. We've lost a little bit, but that is collecting nicely. We have 7,000 odd. Okay, maybe we can... keep an eye out for where the collection trigger point is on this trailer, actually. So, we'll go up the second one. That's obviously what was the front mower, so it's a little bit... I was going to say shorter, but it's a little bit further up than the others' starting points. Let's see if we can just crank up the speed a little bit. We don't want to be sitting here all day. Yeah, it picks up at 3 speed. Fantasy-dastic. We'll see how much of this we can dump in the grass bin. So we missed the whole top edge there. You see that? Obviously took that corner far too tight, and we took our row, which we would be collecting this time, so that's fine. We'll just jiffle over. Right, so jiffle over, try and... Oh, we're not going to get all of it, but that's fine. I'll come around here. Get that. Then we have to jiffle back. Okie dokie, that went. That's much better. Much neater and tidier. Fantastic. Okay, we'll just get. Oh, we did the same this corner that we cut too tight. An angle, which is fine. We'll just jiffle across again. Jiffle in full effect. Oh, we're not jiffling tight enough. Jiffle tighter. Okay, there we go. Boom. Fantastico. Wow, look how mucky this forage wagon has got already. That's a filthy little brute, isn't it? Wow, it must have just rained to get all this muck in. It's on the inside as well. It's flinging muck in. Can't really understand that bit, but wow. We've missed this corner as well. We won't try and do too much to collect it all. I'd rather just try and line up for this bit better. There we go. So we're up to 15,000 litres, almost up to halfway, which is great. Whoa. Now I'm just going to go straight on this bit. And then we'll straighten up and go on that. On the third rung. Try not to jackknife. There we go. Masterfully done. Beautiful. Yep, so we'll get this done. We'll get a load in there. I'm trying to think. We may have to buy a silage pit to dump the rest of the grass in, because I don't think that little grass holder will take too much. I'm not going to bale all the rest of it, because that's just ridiculous. We don't need that many bales. And that many objects being added in the game is more likely to cause problems, you know, with corruptions and calculations and physics issues and all sorts of glitchiness. So yeah, we're not going to add like a million and one bales to the game just to cause it more difficulty. It's all about trying to keep this as stable as possible. So far so good. Really enjoying it. It's really nice to be back on this, actually. It does add a level of depth. Well, not depth, a level of manual work, I should say, which the others don't. The fact that you have to get out of the tractor to hitch up is a nice touch. Feels like you're actually there in the tractor and doing the work, which is quite nice. And I also like the fact that you can pick up bales, pick up trays, pick up things with just your hands and move them about. Yeah, you can get... There used to be in Farm Sim 2013 pitchfork mod where it would allow you to pick up bales and stuff with your hands, but it wasn't quite the same. I might just take these two bits off here. Can I drift over there? Will we get fined for coming on here? We shouldn't do, because we're not technically picking anything up, but we've been fined for less. Missed a big chunk again. It's fine, don't worry about that. We'll once we come to baling, we'll and get some hay, we'll all line it into a row, so it won't matter as much. Okay, great. Let's pick that up and we'll do another turn. What are we up to now? We're up to 24,000. Great. This is probably well in a surplus to what our actual bin can hold. But, hey-ho. We've mowed it. We're going to have to sort it out. So, do we actually have our... No, it's just got 282 in the barn. I'd have to scroll down, which would stop the tractor, to actually look at how much we've got. So I'll hold off for now. Maybe when we get to the corner we can have a look. If we could unload this directly into the barns, that would be awesome. And when I say barns, the pigsty and the barn. Now let's just have a scroll down. So we've got 202 grass in the bin at the moment. So it's going to be quite a significant addition, as you can well imagine. Look at that. Doesn't that look beautiful? Well, as beautiful as these graphics can look. Sorry, just had to change it away because we weren't collecting grass properly. It's a weird trigger point on this. Can't quite work out exactly where it is. It's obviously on that front bit there, but it doesn't seem to be 100% reliable. Yeah, it's doing okay though, isn't it? Okay, what are we coming up to? 29,000. Okay, a couple more runs and we should have a bin full. Well, actually, I'll tell you what, we've probably got more than we can ever hope to fill in the bin anyway, so let's probably just stop it there. We'll come around this corner, pick that up, and let's deactivate that. And let's just see if we can. I hope this is not too big. We can maybe load this. There's the grass pit next to the manure. But hopefully we can load this directly into the shed. That would be pretty awesome. Will it fit? No, it's too big to physically fit, but there is that bale symbol there. So I wonder, can we reverse it up to that symbol and offload? Let's give this a go. See how it works out. It may not work. Probably won't work, but you know. You don't know until you try. Right, now the good thing about this one, I don't think. Oh, it is dropping. Is it going into the. Yes, it is. Look, if you look at the barn, it's filling up the barn. Fantastic! 5,000 litres the barn will take. Okay, that's great. Leaves us with 25,000. Oops. 25,000 in the trailer. Let's see if we can do that with the pigs as well. Is there a marker for the pigs? Yeah, there's a grass marker there. Do you see that? Let's. Oh, actually, we may need to. Let's see if we can reverse it up against the door, or just to the side of the door, to see if that will trigger. If that will fill, that will be awesome. That'd be super duper awesome. Right? Can we? Will that trigger there? No. Okay. Let's try and get it between those, because they're obviously that those green markers are marking the get out of the way trees are marking the where the troughs are on the other side of the wall. But I'm wondering if we can yes, we can offload it straight into them, but we have to be really super accurate, so we have to pull it right up to the ladder on this one. Oh, auto save. So if we have a look, so that's done that. The pigs die. It's taken 300 with that one. Let's just see if we can offload some more into this one. Whoops. Steady now, steady now. Easy does it. Chickens in the way. Gallus on the other side, just to make it a little bit more a challenge, as they like to do. Okay, now let's open the back door. Will it fill up, or is it already full? No, it'll already fill. Ah, okay. So, there's a couple of troughs on the other side, so we'll have to quickly do this. So as the pigs up to the pigs now still at 300, which is interesting. So where's that going? Interesting. Let's just get out of the tractor when we come over here. Oh, there isn't a trough this side, so let's just jump out. Open the doors. So we've got bags of, okay, and we've got bales there, but okay, so it filled those two troughs up. That's fantastic. That's bales. Okay, don't worry about that then. So let's dump the rest into the pit. The grass pit of hell. Well, it's not that bad really, is it? So we've got a hell of a lot of grass still to process. So we will definitely need to buy a silage pit. By the way, Chucky. Okay. Back this in without causing too much damage. Be ace. I bet you this can't take all of it. I bet you it can't. Let's just do that a little bit better. When I say a little bit better, worse in fact. Right, let's push that in. Right, that's a great camera angle by the way. Thanks for that, game. Let's back door, start unloading that. Watch the grass rise. Can we scroll down to see what it's going up to? There we go. 8,000, 9,000, 10,000. Wow, it can hold quite a bit. More than I thought, which is good. 15,000, and it seems to be full. And we've got 10,000 still in the trailer. And the grass is still rising as the animation goes. Okay, so we will need... We'll just park this alongside the greenhouse for now. And we will disconnect, because that can cause glitchiness as well. So we will need to get ourselves a silage bin, because we've maxed everything out and we still got loads in the trailer, and we've got a whole field's worth there. Goodness me. Nothing more has happened in here, literally, because I've recorded this straight after, well, not straight after, but straight from the save point, which was just after the previous episode. Our grass bin is now full. Let's have a quick look, one final look. Oh, that looks beautiful, doesn't it? Look at that. So that can be basically the outcropping of our next field. Should be pretty match for that one, won't it? We probably won't go as far. We'll probably only go to about there where this line is, because obviously the ridge at the top and everything. And down here, I was going to place a silage, wasn't I? Silage pit. So if I go... placeables, storage, silage, which is... How much is this? 4,000, so that's relatively cheap. And we'll probably spring it around and park it next to... Oh no, because we've got the greenhouse there. Maybe we could stick it down here somewhere. We spin it round, maybe... I don't know. Is this our field? This is our field. We could stick it in here, for heaven's sake. Not that we should probably use these for the animals rather than anything else, but... I could potentially turn on its side and stick it in there. I say I could potentially, I can't remember actually how to do that right now, so I'm not going to fiddle around just because I accidentally buy it. But we'll figure out for next time. So yeah, we'll potentially get that as well, which is great. So there's lots to do as long as the game keeps going, eh, Chuck? Indeed. So, I'll just grab the chicken, there's no point really. So thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed this. We got loads of work ahead of us. We've got all that grass, we've got some of it mowed. Not mowed, some of it baled, some of it, I was going to say twisted, spun, I guess. Basically, we need to get it lined, get it tethered, and so it turns into hay, and then we'll bale that as well. And the rest of it we'll have to collect and stick into a silage bin when we buy that, but we may have problems. Or maybe if actually we put it alongside the greenhouse with the entrance here, we'll just have to move this tank and that should be okay. Okay, that might be the best way around it. So thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed this, and join me next time for more Agricultural Simulator 2013. So I'll see you then!